Hi everyone, my name is Mitch Romoshensky, and in this video we will implement drag and drop functionality for the project from my previous video about named router outlet, and we will implement functionality similar what you see right now on your screen. So we will learn some essentials of drag and drop functionality, how to drag element from one container to another one. I hope you will learn something interesting today, so let's get started. First of all, let's be sure that we installed Angular CDK package. This is very important. Without this package, it's not gonna work. And then we have to import the module which is responsible for the drag and drop implementation. So I will go to app module, and somewhere here below in the imports, I'm going to import drag drop model, which comes from CDK drag and drop, right? Cool. Once we have it, we have to do what? We have to create the drop area inside the user details, right? Somewhere here below, we have to create some, you know, rectangle, whatever, where we will drop our image previews. So let's implement it. I will go inside user details, and somewhere here below, I will introduce the new list, and I say that it has class drop area. Nice, and let's add some basic styles for it. So here is some basic styles, and now we see this nice area, or not very nice, but we don't care about beauty of our view for now. Cool. The next step would be to make these previews draggable, yeah? Because now we cannot do it really. And if you want to make some element draggable with Angular CDK drag and drop model, you have to do very simple thing. You have to go to the element you're going to drag, and we're going to drag this Lee element, right? And you have to attach one simple directive called CDK drag. Once you add this directive to any element, you can take any element and drag it around your application. So pretty cool, but a bit useless in our case. We want to transfer it from one list, so to say, to another one. Yeah, we don't want to have such a mess like we have right now. So we have to introduce two drag and drop lists, right? And in order to do this, we have to utilize another directive called CDK drop list, and we will attach the first one to our UL list, yeah, so kind of parent of this preview elements. And the same we're going to do for our drop area we created a few minutes ago, yeah. So this is the list, this is indicates that the area where we can drop some item, yeah, and we have two, the first one and the second one. Cool. And having these two directives, we have to connect them together, right? So they know about each other. And in order to achieve this, we have to use the third special directive called CDK drop list group. And this directive should be attached on the level above. So our drop list should be, let's say, children for this directive. And our nearest parent will be in app component. Parent, I mean, not component, but HTML element. Yeah, and so this is our sidebar. Here inside we have the first drop list, and this is the section with details. Here inside we have the second drop list. And as I said, our drop list group should be a parent. So we will attach this directive to our main element, and it's going to be CDK drop list group. And this directive will group all child drop lists together. Doesn't matter how many of them you have. You can have, I don't know, 3, 4, 5 drop lists. They will be connected automatically within this directive. I hope it's pretty much clear so far. Yeah. Now we have our drop list connected, and we can listen actually for some events which are happening when we drag and drop stuff, right? So in user details, let's start to listen CDK drop list dropped. Yeah, when we drop some element within this list, it will fire some event. And let's create some handler for it. I will create a method called drop. It has some event. And here below, I will create this method. And as an argument, we get the event. And the type of it is CDK drag drop. And this is generic. We have to define the type which we get here. And this is basically a photo array, right? And we have to import photo. It's not imported. Okay, we have this interface within photo server component and we don't export it. Let's exclude it from here and put it in some separate component component file. I will name it photo.ts, and we're going to export this interface here and adjust it in our photos sidebar. And inside the user details, also we can import it from here. And let's have a look, what do we have inside this event? As you see that this is quite complex object. Let's investigate what is inside and try to drop some element inside. So I will open debug console. I will zoom it for you. And now we try to drag it. And once I drop it, you can see that there is some big object, and let's have a look what is inside. So we have container. This is the container, this one, yeah, where we actually drop the element. Then we have previous container, the container where this element have taken, yeah. And this is the item itself, the item which we dropped or dragged and dropped. But here is one problem, and namely, we don't have really data which represent these subnails, which represents the drop list and so on. So the only one thing we have, if we open as example container, we have just some event emitters, we have reference to HTML element itself. It's not really what we would like to have. We would like to have the real data for it, and we can do it. This CDK drop list has a property, CDK drop list data. And here you can already associate some data which represents this list, right? And we would like to put our photos as a value for this drop list data. So I'm gonna refactor it a little bit, and I will add ngif directive, and let's say that when we resolved photos, save it to variable photos, and we provide this value for drag drop list data property, and we replace our ng4 with this. Yeah, so there will be the same basically behavior, but when we drag and drop something here and try to inspect, so previous container, this is where we has taken the element, and you can see now we have the data, and if we expand it, we see our albums here. So the array which is rendered right here. This is exactly what we would like to have. And now we have to do the similar thing for our drop area in user details. So I will do it like this, but here I have to create this property, and it's going to be array of photos. By default, it's empty array. Here we go. And now if we drag and drop some element and expand this, so the container where we dropped the data is empty array, right? Because we have no elements here, but the previous container is our data here. All right, I hope it's clear for now. And now we have to transfer item from one array to another one, basically. This is everything we have to do. And in order to do this, we will be using another helper function, which comes with Angular CDK, and it's called transfer array item. Here we go. And this transfer array item, it takes four arguments. Basically, this is the current array. This is where we pull data. The target array, this is the array where we drop our new item. And then the current index and target index, this is the index where it was in the previous container, and the new index where this element will be placed in the new array. Okay, so we can provide event previous container data. So this is container where we pulled the element. Now we have to provide the container data. So this is our current array. And then event previous index and event current index. All right, now we can save it, go to the browser, and I drag and drop it here, and nothing has been changed. Why? Ah, because we forgot, sorry guys, we forgot to render our photos within this well. So we have to create a li, then I create some ng4. And say that let photo of photos, and the source value of this image will be photo thumbnail URL. And let's say that width will be 60 pixels. And you may reasonably ask how we will get new elements inside this photo, so we don't explicitly mutated, we don't add the new elements to this array. Yeah, and the thing is that here when we transfer element, this container data, this is the link to our photos array. Yeah, we take this property, we provide to drop list data right here. And data, which is right here, contains the reference to our property. So once we mutated data here inside the container data, this is the same that we mutated our photos property. And that's why we will see this transferred objects right here. Okay, I hope now it's a bit more clear. Now I hope that it will work. Replace it and yeah, everything works fine. However, I would suggest you maybe make some little improvements. First of all, I would add maybe some animation, and you can do it easily by adding some special CSS. These two classes, this is what you have to add in order to have some animation. And now we can save and try to drag. All right, we have animation, but you see that view is completely broken. If you have never worked with Angular drag and drop, you will encounter this definitely. And the problem is that at the moment when you start to drag some element, you see this blinking. At this time, Angular creates another HTML element, a placeholder for dragged element. And basically the image there inside, it needs some time to be rendered. But once you start dragging, probably this is just a theory, I didn't really investigate it in depth, but I think that at this time, Angular already calculates the height for this placeholder, and it happened before the image is rendered. So the height will be definitely wrong, maybe some 1 or 0 pixels. Yeah, and Angular, when we moving it here, it considers that the height of dragged element is very little. This just, I don't know, 0 pixels maybe. And because the calculation is wrong, it has this strange behavior, and you can easily fix it by introducing the fixed height for the dragged element. So for our Lee, we can say that height is 70 pixels. Yeah. And once I save it and try to drag, you see that now it works properly, because now we have fixed height. Angular just read this value, it knows that defined height is 70 pixels. It's immediately like uses this height for calculation. That's why, yeah, we have proper reorder, and I can drag and put it here. Yeah. So it works as expected. If you want to have the vice versa behavior, so put it back, you just have to make it draggable right here in user details, CDK drag, and you need to copy paste this drop method to the photo sidebar. Say that you are listening for dropped event and create drop handler, and here below you should do pretty much the same what we have done before. Curly braces, and yeah, now we can drop it here, drop it there, and then I can move it back like this and move it back like this. As easy as that. Yeah, you can improve the view a little bit, whatever, but that's your homework. Alright guys, that was it. I hope it was interesting, and if so, please share this video with your colleagues. I would highly appreciate it, and don't forget to leave your feedback in comment sections, subscribe to my channel, and of course check out my video courses. There are a couple of them, they are very interesting, about GraphQL, about Angular material theming. Discounts are in the video description, so it's worth it. I wish you a productive week, stay safe, and see you in the future.